Hey there, baseball fans, it's Ben, and today I don't have wax packs, I got jumbo packs. Jumbo packs are kind of more cards and bigger than your traditional wax packs, and they usually come in, also called cello packs, because they come in cellophane, and back in the day when cards were always in wax, cellophane was a little bit different. These FLIR actually aren't in cellophane, they're still in the plastic, but 91 FLIR was wax there. And you can see this 1988 Topps jumbo pack is like double jumbo. So so I just thought it'd be fun to take a few of these jumbo packs and see what we can find. All right, so we're gonna start off with the junkiest of the junk, 1988 Donruss. Back in the day was 99 cents, and this is a jumbo pack with 36 cards in there, which is more than twice as much as a normal pack would have. Of course, there are no wax stains on these jumbo packs, which is one of the big selling points back then. But this set is pretty, pretty bad. Even the best cards you can get in here, like the Tom Glavin rookie and whatnot, still, like, there's just so many of them. It's not even that much of a thrill to pull them out. But look at this! It is a thrill when you get Sean Dunston, your favorite player. Well, probably not yours, but my favorite player. I have probably, I don't know, more than a dozen of these cards here, and this one's pretty cut off center, but I always love pulling one of these out. He's looking nice and strong there, heading into what will be one of his best years. 1988, he was an all-star that year, so excited to get that one. Got three puzzle pieces, no, just two, I mean. And let's see what else we can pull here. There's Goose Gossage, Diamond King's checklist, Diamond King Andy Van Slyke. Something sticking. There we go. Roger McDowell. Tommy John. Now, I'll never say that a pack where. Oh, there's Dwight Gooden. So that's something. And look at that. Those. Jeez. I mean, those few years from 84 really through 87, it's just hard to beat that. I mean, look at those numbers. Especially in 84 and 85, coming out of the gate, second year, 24 wins, 16 complete games, 268 strikeouts. I mean, that is dominance. 1.53 ERA. Craziness. Just a shame that he, had the demons he had to battle through there. So, not the greatest pack, but any pack where you pull your favorite player is a good one in my eyes. All right, we're going to jump to a jumbo pack of 30 cards from FLIR, which is just like a double pack, essentially. A lot of times these manufacturers would also put special cards in these jumbo packs or whatnot that you wouldn't get anywhere else. So, although it's just a double pack, they give you three stickers. So that's funny. No provisions, it looks like, but this banana series, see what we get. Actually, these are really smooth and they're not gritty like the normal jumbo packs are, which is nice. There's Ruben Sierra. Willie Wilson. There's a Ryan Sandberg. All right. So we are doing pretty well. Two packs and two of my favorite players that I have in my personal collection. So, again, even if we don't get any big stars beyond that, then anytime you can pull your favorite players out, you're doing pretty well. And we don't. We don't have anyone else. All right. I'm going to open up this double jumbo now. This is 1988. I do think there was gum in here. Just really clinging to that. Now, this does have a special rookie card set, so you can get 22 glossy rookie cards. I think this just has one of those special rookie cards in here that you can't get anywhere else. So that'll be fun to see what we pull out of here. Otherwise, 1988 Topps is one of those massively overproduced sets that you've all opened a million of those cards and seen a million times. So I'm looking, they're already bent over a little bit, but Billy Ripken, so he's our rookie that year. Wow, this Bob Stanley's really messed up somehow, but Billy Ripken. Now, the question I would have is, do they really think Billy Ripken was going to be a special rookie, or do they just say, yeah, that's Cal Ripken's brother, we'll take our chances? All right, I'm just going to throw this Bob Stanley out. It's really messed up. I hate for someone that gets these cards next to have that in there. Frank Viola, nice picture of him. Oh, there's a Sean Dunston right there with Manny Trio. That's a good one. I like it. I like it a lot. So I'll add that to my collection too. This is just, so far, I'm batting 1,000 on getting my favorite players out of here. There's Dave Stewart with his signature windbreaker jacket. Bill Buckner with his signature eyebrows and mustache. An amazing head of hair. Cecil Fielder before he headed off to Japan. Before he came back and became a home run hero. Oral Hershiser in the midst of his top-notch career. Right there before he fell off. Paul O'Neill. I think that might be a rookie card for him. Yeah, I think it is. So Paul O'Neill and the Reds. That's a good card. I don't know that I've seen that one, at least recently, either. So, Danny Tartable. There's a straw man, Daryl Strawberry, at the height of his powers. Rick Aguilera. All right. So our rookie might be a little bit of a bust, I think, but that's another one of my favorite players, so can't complain too much. All right, so side two of this mega jumbo pack. Again, 90 cards is a lot. I don't know if it doesn't have a price on it or anything, but pretty good value. Try to keep these gum pieces in here. There's gum dust all over these, and yum yum. That is covered. Burt Blylevin covered in gum. Stained and covered. So I'm going to throw that one out of here. There's John Franco. Was he wearing? Yes, he's wearing Rex specs. That is remarkable. I always enjoy, I know that I open these a lot. There's Dave Winfield. Nice card for him. I know I open these a lot, but like if I think back to 1988, I mean, these cards haven't seen the light of day in 30 plus years. It's pretty amazing. You know, the last time these felt the fresh air was 30 plus years ago. Not a whole lot going on here, folks. Wait, I think in our last video, we were going to look up Steve Ontiveros. Let's put him aside and maybe we'll look him up now. There's our future star, Joey Meyer. Potopsy was a little off on that one. Paul Molitor, that's a decent card for our last one. So again, not great stuff there. Paul O'Neill's pretty good. And got the Sean Dunston Cubs card. And our last one here is 1991 Topps jumbo pack, 34 cards, just barely over a double pack. And this is no gum in these, so that was one of the drawing points of these, that you don't have to have the gum or the wax build up or wax stains. There's Carlton Fisk. It's a great shot of Cecil Fielder barreling in. Batter behind him telling him, get down. So clearly the action happening there. Carlton Fisk, one of the greatest catchers in the game ever. It's Roberto Alomar. Paul O'Neill again. It's a Paul O'Neill kind of day. Dave Winfield also, again, you know, I always tend to develop some themes here. There's Will Clark, had a great run of seasons. Dave Righetti as well. Julio Franco, the All-Star. And that'll do it. So no majors in here. It wasn't really the greatest pack rip I've ever seen, but, you know, some stuff that I like, and then some of my favorite players there, so I'll take it. And let's take a look at Steve Ontiveros. I don't know much about him. Played for the A's, clearly. Alright, so let's find out what his deal was from Indiana. We'll look him up and see what we can find. There he is. The pitcher, right? Ooh, there's an infielder, too. So there he is. Played from 85 to 2000, so 15-year career. That's good. The A's, the Phillies, the Mariners, the Red Sox. University of Michigan. Still alive and living in Mexico. No, he was born in Mexico. Okay. 34 and 31, 367 ERA, 382 strikeouts, so not a stellar career. But he was an all-star in 95 and the ERA leader in 94, so something in there was working. So although he, and plus from 85 to 2000, that's 15 years, but he only had a 10-season career. So must have had a up and down from the minors. And he got the loss in the All-Star game that year. He owns and operates Players' Choice Academy in Scottsdale, Arizona. He's a pitching coach for the Chinese national baseball team in the Beijing Olympics, which is funny because he's not Chinese, I don't think, but that doesn't say much about him. But he does own and operate Players' Choice Academy. So a baseball lifer, played for a number of years, still teaching kids how to play the game. So good for you, Steve. And hats off to you for making the bigs and making baseball your life. The rest of you, we'll see you next time.